Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Tina. Some days ago, I made a blog post about how unmotivating school can be and how it's just the second week of school, and I'm already feeling bored of classes and classes seem uninteresting. I don't know if I'm the only one in this situation, if I'm the only one that at a point in time in school you just totally get uninterested in classes and you go to class and all you want to do is sleep or use your phone. I don't know why I'm facing this right now in the second week, but I'm gonna blog post about it. And thank you for everyone who commented and gave me some advice to get over this time. So my viewers, so if you haven't read the blog post, I will leave the link down below, and if you have any tips or advice for me about it, I will be glad to listen to your advice. You can leave it in the blog comment section, or you can leave it in the comment section right here below. So I decided to share the advice I got from people from my comment section, and I hope you learn one or two things from it. And if you do learn something, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel. First comment here is from Anonymous, and he said, "You have to stick notes on walls reminding you of your resolutions. You need to write it down on the front page of your notebooks too. Finally, you just have to fight that laziness. Only you can." Thank you, Anonymous, for this post, for this advice. I really am going to fight the laziness. About the resolutions, on the blog post, I also stated how at the beginning of the semester, before the semester starts, you have resolutions. I'm going to do this in this semester. You have schedules. I'm going to follow this. I'm going to study every day. And once the semester starts, everything just disappears. Like, you just lose interest. So thank you so much, Anonymous, for this comment. I am going to do my best to follow these tips. I already have. I started sticking notes, just tiny quotes and some encouragement on some of my notebooks. So thank you. Next comment is from @empire. He said, "Isn't it so obvious? Virtually every student experiences this at least once during their school periods. I think it's normal we feel lazy. Not that I'm trying to convince myself, because I do it like so often, but we still survive it, especially when a teacher hints out specific lines and says it will come out in some tests or exams. We actually do listen, but we are humans, and some are just smart and a bit lazy, no matter what." Well, it is kind of good to know I'm not the only one in this situation. There are lots of us in this situation, and I hope whatever advice I have here really helps us get out of it. I really do hope. Thank you, @empire, for your comments. The next comment is from Chilala. He said, "So true about the resolutions and all those things. We tend to get lazy, and that's normal. What I have learned during this short period I've been in medical school so far is that you can't or don't expect to get motivation from your classmates or any other person. Stick reminders on your wall, yes, and write them down in any book you usually open each day. That will help, because I found it helpful. Even when you feel lazy, try by all means never to procrastinate, because that's where it all starts from. Be self-motivated and constantly remind yourself of what you wouldn't like seeing in yourself. And when you're done, that will help you better yourself each day. Hope this helps. Thanks." Thank you, Chilala, for your comment. I have really started sticking notes on some of my notebooks, and procrastination, I am getting rid of it in my life. I have a planner that I write everything I want to achieve each day on it, and I do my best to achieve everything I have written on my planner. So gradually I'm getting rid of procrastination in my life, and I really hope we help ourselves get rid of this thing called procrastination. Next comment is from Sumtu. She said, "Interestingly, the same things happened to me in the first weeks of school. I blamed some of my teachers for being slow and boring. My chemistry teacher talks like he's sleeping, and he talks a lot. I was so sleepy in his first classes, but I got used to it, and now I am more attentive in his class. My teacher for American literature talks as though he's asleep as well. I have to have a cup of coffee and muffin to keep me up in his class, even today. At first I blamed my instructors, but then I realized that I had to make A's in these courses. It's definitely mandatory to make A's in them. Thus, I started making the most of my planner. I'm trying to change my circadian rhythm. I sleep earlier when I can, wake up in the middle of the night to study, and then go back for a quick nap before I leave for school at 7 a.m. School coupled with work is not easy, but every semester, I find a way to adjust to the unique nature of the semester. In a nutshell, it might not necessarily be laziness. It might just be making some little but helpful adjustments. Thank you, Somto, for your comment. Using a planner is very recommended by me. And I hope you're really able to balance your school and work life. You can't keep blaming the instructors for our problems because we have a life out of school, and if you don't know how to balance it, you cannot blame it on your instructors. And we really need to ace the courses, so we just have to find ways to do it. So thank you for your comment. Balancing your sleep circle is also very important, sleeping early in order to wake up early. I hope you're learning a few from this comment I'm reading. The next comment is from Tunga. He said, it is normal to get bored sometimes during a lecture, especially when the teacher is acting like he did not take his breakfast or lunch. I often feel sleepy in class too, losing focus and all. But what I discovered is whenever I got bored in class, I found myself doing another thing if not sleeping. Yeah, but the thing that helped me is this one. Let me take it this way. When you feel lazy, what do? You sleep, you log on Facebook, chat with someone you don't often chat with on WhatsApp, or rather play Temple Run on your phone. It's nothing so serious, trust me. So I started weighing the alternatives. I take this long, boring lecture. Is it worth it? Is the news feed I'm reading on Facebook better than this lecture? Yes, it's boring, but it's just boring for that moment because I can go on Facebook anytime. So I refuse to let my brain play a trick on me. The brain always opts for the easier, entertaining things like sleeping and looking on people's statuses on Facebook and WhatsApp. So I started telling myself that, dude, you need to focus. Now you will chat with that person who is probably on his or her own free time when you are free, or sleep when it is time to sleep. Now it's time to get stuff from this boring teacher. It plays a trick on your brain and activates all those neurons, and yeah, it's kind of working for me. Thank you, Tunga, for your comments. This is working for you, and I hope it works for me and for everyone watching this now. In school, you really want to become a medical doctor, you really want to become a lawyer or whatever it is, but you realize that there are some classes that just get very boring. So you just have to find means and ways to get over this. And actually, I am making a video with Tunga about how to stay motivated in medical school, because he's a very motivated person. He's one of the most motivated people in school I have met my stay here in China. So I'm making a video with him. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel, you better do that now so you don't miss that video. It is going to be very, very educative. So that's all the comments I have now, and I hope you have learned a thing or two from this comment, because I sure have. So one extra tip I have for you all that's also working for me is just get all your study materials ready so you don't have excuses. At the first week of school, I was having lots of excuses, saying when I want to study, I just say, I don't have the slides, or I don't have a pen, I haven't bought notebooks. I just kept giving myself excuses. Just buy everything you need and get them ready. There will be no excuse for you not to study or not to go along with the teacher in class, because having PPT slides also helps you. I set this out in my note-taking tips. If you haven't watched that, I will leave the link down below so you watch and learn a few tips about how to take notes in class and some concentration tips. So thank you guys for watching this video. Feel free to comment, like, give it a thumbs up, and also subscribe to my channel. If there are any video ideas you have for me, any videos you want me to make, feel free to also leave it in the comment section. Feel free to email me. And thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in my next video. Follow me up on my social media. I'll see you in my next video. Bye bye.